Today, I want to talk about Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Other than being the source of some of the world's favorite bad CGI and fashion memes, he's also one of the world's favorite people. At 250 million Instagram followers, he's the second most popular person on the platform, right behind soccer player Cristiano Ronaldo. His films have drawn over $6 billion at the box office, and in the 90s, Johnson sported two of the most famous sideburns in TV history. We may not have known it at the time, but the guy was one pork pie head away from being in Real Big Fish. To be completely honest, I haven't really been much of a fan of The Rock's wrestling or movies for most of the time he's been famous. The furthest I got into the Fast and Furious franchise was watching Tokyo Drift and then knowing in my heart that cinema could never get better than that. But at this point, I can't ignore the guy. He's this generation's Arnold, plus he's got the TV show, the tequila, and the very probable presidential run. He's everywhere. In the past few years, I couldn't help but notice in his interviews that for being one of the biggest men alive right now, he tended to talk a lot about the women in his life with more passion and respect than I had heard from other guys of his stature.
And that's why I have such respect for strong women, because I was raised by one.
So is your mom your running mate?
No, although she would love that.
So I couldn't help but wonder, is The Rock a feminist?
He said, girl power. Yeah.
Is he just maybe that rare male public figure legitimately trying to use his power to promote women? Before we get to that answer, I want to remind you to subscribe to this channel and hit that bell if you're interested in more videos that talk about masculinity and challenge the ideas that we grew up with about how to be a man. Now, I should probably define what being a feminist even means. There are still a lot of guys I know who get the definition a little wrong. Feminism is the belief in social, economic, and political equality of the sexes. Equality being a tricky term for some people. Guys, feminism is not the belief that women are better than men. That's just been a trick to demonize women trying to get their fair share. Being a feminist is about outwardly supporting women and providing genuinely fair opportunities to them where they haven't had those available before. And it's not just a label or a fun thing to put in your bio. Feminism is a belief that finds its way into how you look at the world and how you make decisions with the people in your life. So how does The Rock's feminism show up in his life and philosophy? In about as many ways as one could describe The Rock.
The trail blazing, eyebrow raising, jabroni beating, wow, pie eating, heart stopping, elbow dropping, people's champ, The Rock.
First off, he's an infinitely proud and supportive girl dad. Now, I realize that just because someone is a girl dad, it doesn't automatically make them a feminist. I mean, look at Brett Kavanaugh.
My daughters, Margaret and Liza, are smart, strong, awesome girls.
And I never sexually assaulted anyone.
But what really sticks out to me about his relationship with his three daughters is that he gives them the type of advice and guidance that can only come from a guy who believes they can accomplish anything or even accomplish more than him.
Can you say, I'm an awesome girl.
Awesome girl.
I'm a smart girl.
Smart girl.
I'm a very smart girl. And I want you to say, I could do anything.
Anything.
That's right.
When you listen to the passion in his voice, you can tell that he believes in their strength and wants a world that respects them as equals.
I always wanted to be a great dad. I always wanted to give Simone things that I felt I never got. I've realized that the most important thing that I could do with my daughter is lead our life with love.
I mean, leading with love? How often do you see action stars that can talk like that in real life who do this? That's not just feminism, that's real masculinity. That's courageous human shit right there. You know what's also courageous? Believing in your wife's business savvy so much, you make her your company's partner, then you get divorced, and you still have her run your business afterward. I mean, that is the story of Danny Garcia and The Rock. I would pay that bullshit Disney Plus extra charge to watch a movie right now that explained how they made that situation work out.
Marriage wasn't in our cards. We're great friends,
But we both had an appetite for business and to accomplish things. And we thought, well, what if we continued to do business together? And do you think we can? And it felt like it was like we could make something happen. And we did.
And it's not like she didn't deserve the gig. After Garcia met Johnson in college at the University of Miami, we got some kids over here. Sounded a lot cooler when I said that in between beer bongs in the stadium parking lot. If you couldn't tell, I also went to the U. Wait, enhance? Enhance? Oh God. Well, I guess those fish just keep getting real bigger. After college, Danny Garcia became an associate vice president at Merrill Lynch, eventually starting her own wealth management firm. But she left it all to manage Dwayne's career, produce his movies, and eventually co-own the XFL Football League, making her the first woman to own an equal or majority ownership stake in a major professional sports league in the United States. That's some major boss shit. And she had the opportunity to do it all because The Rock saw her intrinsic value. She was the smartest and most qualified person he knew that could help him reach his big goals. And she happened to be a woman, which seems to be the same case when he picked a decorated military woman as his vice president on the show Young Rock.
The person who I have chosen to become our next vice president of the United States is General Monica Jackson.
Ms. Jackson, quick question.
And yeah, I get that TV shows aren't real. I mean, if they were, I'd be doing this video on my brother Michael Rapaport's Instagram.
Some moron drove the car into the oil changing pit, and I might have to go to a funeral.
Well, I could pick up mom and dad.
Johnson choosing a woman of color as his running mate in his TV show is just another sign that he wants to be part of progress. And he sees raising women up as a part of his potential presidential ideal of bringing all the people together.
I have a goal and an interest and an ambition to unite our country. Now, right now, we're a divided country, and that's okay. We're going to work through it, and we're going to get better.
Plus, he also publicly supported the first female VP when he endorsed the Joe Biden-Kamala Harris ticket in 2020. So clearly, the guy thinks women deserve positions of power. And according to him, that's because he was raised by a powerful woman.
Yeah, I really put my mom through it. But she never gave up on me, and she always showed me what true strength really is.
It's when talking about his mom that The Rock really lights up.
If there's differences, if there's this, whatever's going on in the world, and moms come around, you always got to take care of the mamas.
And also on top of all that, in 2017, writer Anne Victoria Clark popularized a sexual harassment prevention tool called The Rock Test, helping men to stay safe from possibly harassing women in the workplace by treating every woman the same way they would Dwayne The Rock Johnson. I mean, the guy has his own feminist test that he 100% endorses. Now, I'm sure he isn't perfect. Like most of us, me included, The Rock probably talked in ways that weren't as respectful to women in the past. But the only thing I found in my research was a video of him actually preventing a creepy pseudo-sexual scene where Vince McMahon was going to force Trish Stratus to kiss his bare butt.
Seen a ghost?
Whoa, 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 whoa! You leave your pants down!
Huh? Professional wrestling is deeply weird. I will say, in a way, The Rock is actually in a very safe spot to be a feminist. He's the manliest man most people can think of. Even his nickname speaks to one of traditional masculinity's most coveted traits, stoicism. The Rock. Dwayne Johnson is who many of us think of when we think about the height of the male figure. And so, The Rock is so undoubtedly masculine that he can afford to lose any of that social currency that men have with each other by supporting women.
Part of what makes you who you are. You're a real man, but you get it. You have a softer side.
Well.
And he can also express traditionally feminine traits, like leading with love and speaking from the heart.
You know, really the most important thing that I've learned with my daughters is to just be there and listen. Having an expanded capacity to listen and be more tender and gentle.
Few men would be brave enough to question his masculinity because of his support of women. And while his fame and stature are the exact reason why his feminism is important, it's also essential for young men to know and understand that they are strong, courageous, and they are good leaders by supporting women's equity even if they don't look like The Rock. I believe it was that pre-social media influencer Mahatma Gandhi who said, "I suppose leadership at one time meant muscles, but today it means getting along with people." Funny enough, The Rock gives us both, but true leaders see the strength in cooperation and equality. A guy who grew up poor, black, Samoan, getting through it all by the power of his mother's will, that's a guy who understands the strength of oppressed groups like women. Leadership can mean muscles and getting along with people. You just have to be at the gym at 4 a.m. to do it. Wait, is that true?
Don't you wake up at like 3 in the morning to work out?
About 4.
Okay.
Sleeping in these days, huh?
I'm sleeping in.
I'm sorry, what? When the hell are feminist leaders supposed to go to bed? 8 p.m.? Maybe he is an unrealistic role model. Oh yeah, no. No, he's still human. To me, The Rock shows us that it's time to stop treating feminist like another bad word. It's not about being against men. It's about finding the right person for the job, no matter what their gender is. To me, if you can look like this and have a family like this, but still talk like this,
lead our life with love.
Why would guys want to do it any other way? Be sure to subscribe to my channel to get even more videos about evolving masculinity and helping the inner lives of men. See you next time on Real Feels.